Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I've been doing a lot of Excel videos covering conditional formatting recently. All the videos I've recently done will be down below. Today's video has to do with conditional formatting. Someone asked me, how do you handle betweens? Because it's pretty simple, but I got a couple tips in here. I'm going to do between with dates, but I'll also cover numbers. So let's just dive right into here. So what you're looking at right here, don't worry about column F. Don't worry about column G, H, and I. I'm just planning to where I'm headed. Since I've been a YouTuber, I've done over 780 videos that are public. Last year, I did 161 for the year 2021. So I've got my view count for every video sitting here, and I've got the date published. So all I care about in this example is column B for numbers and column C for dates. So let's go ahead and just jump right into this. I'm going to go to cell B2. That's got the first number in it. Before you do conditional formatting, you usually select your range. That's Control, Shift, down arrow. I got all the numbers selected. I want to see videos that are between 100,000 and 300,000 views. So I come down here and I go to highlight sales rules. We'll keep coming here and go to between 100,000. I don't care what fill color you use. I'm going to use green. Hit OK. Let's do a sort largest to smallest and see if this worked. Back to the top. There is my view count between 100,000 and 300,000 sitting right there. What I don't like about what I just did, because it was really simple, if you think about it, is unless you sort this, even if you sort it, you really don't know what range that I put in for the low number and the high number. The same is going to apply with dates. So that's why I like to come up here in the header row and add in here the numbers I'm looking for. So let me do this again, conditional formatting, clear rules, entire sheet. I'm looking for 100,000. You don't have to put it in bold, but it's nice. 300, and then we're going to test it real quick and tweak it. So there's two advantages to what I'm doing. One, everyone can see what I'm looking for up here now. Just a little formatting. Cell G1 has got the low number. Cell I1 has got the top range. Go back and highlight these numbers again. Conditional formatting. Still going to do between, so that didn't change. But now, instead of typing in numbers, I'm going to reference the cell. That is G1. Make sure it is absolute reference, meaning the dollar signs are in there. Notice I cleared out this and then I'm going to click on I1. That looks good. That looks good. Don't care what color. Hit OK. Quick sort largest to smallest. Let's see if it worked. Back to the top. Control Home will take you to the top. There is 100 to 300 people can look and see over here, regardless of how it's sorted. But even if it's sorted, they know the range I picked. Quick test. If I do 350,000 in I1, I should pick up these two numbers. 350,000. And I do. That is conditional formatting with numbers. The same applies with dates. Let's go ahead and do this first date. In the year 2021, I published 161 videos to YouTube. Let's go find them real quick. Conditional formatting, highlight cells, rules. I could, just so you know this, I could sit in here and type in the dates again. 1/1/2021, 12/31/2021. But I want to reference these cells, G1. I1, hit OK. I'm expecting possibly nothing. That is OK. I don't care. The reason is I need to go and format these. 1/1/2021, 12/31/2021. If you recall, dates are numbers. The date January 1, 1900 is the number one in Excel. So I just need, I technically don't have to, but I'm going to go format these as dates. You don't have to format them as dates. I could have left them as numbers. But now here we go. Highlight C2 to the bottom. Conditional formatting, highlight cells rules between G1, I1, hit OK, quick sort, back to the top, slow down, scroll just slowly, there you go. And let's make sure all 161 are in there. They are, I don't care. Just to test this, I'm going to add the date 1-6-2022. And that is correct because the between should pick up that last one. So it got the last three, the third, the fourth, and the sixth. That's all I got today. Anyway, feel free to subscribe, ring the bell. If you have any comments or questions about conditional formatting using dates or numbers with between, please let me know. Have a great day. Thank you.